it's been a little while since the last Land Rover update, but she's still in quite regular use. In fact, I've used 5 days this week commuting to work. The modern car, 20 years younger, failing to start in the cold weather. Anyway, one or two people have noticed that the Land Rover is now on a galvanised chassis, and that was done back in July, I think it was. And I actually had a garage do that, because I've no longer got the time to do that sort of work myself, and frankly not the space to do it either. It would have taken me a year or two to do it, and I'd have gone through every nut and bolt. So to get a garage to do it, I think they completed the change in 6 days, but they actually made quite a nice job of it. My brief to them was to do the chassis swap for a minimum of cost, but making a good quality job. They certainly found that balance and did a really nice job for me, so I was very pleased with that. Let's just have a quick look. She's absolutely filthy because she's been well used through the bad weather, but nice and shiny under there. I elected not to paint the chassis. Some people paint galvanised chassis, but you know, I see the extra paint and so on as a bad thing, unless you really go to trouble with the application, which would have cost me too much in this case. Then there is a chance of it trapping water underneath, and you know, you get the problems that the bitumen created on my original chassis. The bitumen had hidden a lot of moisture and rotted things out. She's fairly scruffy these days. I think maybe next year a bit of a repaint is in order. I've done one or two more cosmetic jobs, which I just haven't had a chance to do in the past. I had the rear window out, for example, and cleaned up all the retainers, resealed it. Got a trim on the back door now. The frame's been painted. Much the same inside. I'd like to fit LaSalle headlining at some point, which would just probably bring the noise down a little more. And maybe do something about the carpet on the side to the hardtop. It needs the side windows resealing, so that's a job for the future. There is a little story about this beer crate. I went to the Amberley Classic Land Rover show recently, and having got there and parked up, I jumped in the back to cook breakfast, and it was an absolutely horrible day, lashing down. This German registered Santana 88 pulled up, and the owner came over and he asked me if I was a steam woolly in perfect English. Anyway, he held up the beer crate and said, "This is for you." There was about 30 odd bottles of beer in there, and he had driven 1,000 kilometres from Germany and brought the beer on the off chance that I'd be there to say thank you for the YouTube videos on the work that I did on my Land Rover. And he said it had helped him out with the restoration of his. So I didn't quite know what to say at the time, but it really brightened up an otherwise wet and horrible day. So there's some great people out there, particularly in the world of old Land Rovers. Oh yeah, there's another little job that I've done. This bit was missing. So I recently replicated the missing piece. Apparently it would have had sort of haz cards in the side for hazardous loads, whatever that may have been. I guess explosives being a military vehicle. Another job done, the passenger side door top was falling off, and it was really quite rotten. So I've got a pair of these galvanised tops. But I've only done this one so far, so that's all been reglazed, which has made the vehicle somewhat more watertight. On a day like this, the footwell would have been, well, sloshing about at the moment. It does still get a bit of moisture inside, as they all seem to, but underneath the acoustic matting, I've now fitted these grills just loosely in place, and that's made all the difference. The moisture now gets away and it keeps the footwells dry, which is important from a preservation point of view. Well, this time of year you need the red muff on, it just doesn't run very well otherwise. Let's just have a quick peek under the front. Still fairly tidy under there. Obviously she's not a show vehicle, quite grubby, but I try and keep it in good nick. I certainly need to adjust the tappet soon, haven't done that for quite a long time. But I should mention a guy called Martin Sharp on the Series Land Rover group. If you look back to the SU conversion videos, you'll find that there was a pancake filter fitted. Well, I happened to see Martin post a picture of one of these elbows which he's made. In fact, he 3D prints these. And he very kindly offered to send me one for a charitable donation. So that's what I did. He supplied it with a breather hose attachment, but having this bit, I've used the original fitting and I've made a plug to go in there. It's made a huge difference. The intake noise was pretty bad before. I'd come to get used to it really, forgotten how loud it is. And this has brought the noise right down, as you'll see. So all I had to do is get a hose to convert to this size, and I've just extended my 4-bath air filter pipe a little bit. I've then used the original hose. You could fit a longer hose, but I had all these bits, so that was easy. The 4-bath filter is very much more efficient than the old pancake filter and gives much smoother running. So yeah, she's not too bad. Still running fairly sweetly. What else have we had to do? Oh, she's had a clutch. She had a clutch during the chassis change and a rear main seal on the engine as that was starting to leak. That's brought the oil consumption right down. Regular servicing. I've uprated the headlights. I've gone to some super bright lamps now. She's now running a Roma drive, of course. I don't think that was fitted in the last video.
I'll get underneath and show you that in a minute.
Let's just have a look at those headlights.
So yeah, you probably won't see a lot of difference in the daylight like this, but they are much better at night. Let's have a look at that overdrive.
The great advantage of the Global Roma drive. The great advantage of the Roma drive is that it shares the transfer box oil, and it's an epicyclic gearbox as well, very much quieter than the old ferry unit. I think my only criticism of it is the engagement.
The first time you use it on any drive, it's crunchy and I have to double clutch it in, but after that it's obviously getting plenty of oil and it's then very happy. So it just needs careful use for that first change. We've been all over this year, covered a lot of miles, some long trips as well. Very capable vehicle, but steady.